Yes, student, this one is video number 4. This is now the crystal field splitting energy, or this is also known as crystal field stabilizing energy. In short, you can call it what? CFS, and E stand for energy or stabilizing. Now, crystal field splitting energy or crystal field stabilizing energy. This is denoted by del O. O stands for octahedral. So, this is for octahedral complexes. This is known as the difference between the energy of the two sets. I am writing here crystal field splitting energy, which is what denoted by del O, is the difference between two degenerate sets of orbitals. Okay, that is what T2g, okay, which is decreasing the energy by minus 0.4 for each orbitals. And second one is what? Eg, that is what? Two orbitals, okay, each one increases the energy by what? Plus 3.5, okay, magnitude. Now the CFSE energy, which is denoted by del 0, it is equal to, okay, this is what? Differences in the energy. So how can we find the difference? It is equal to what? 0.4 minus into, suppose x is the number of orbital, okay, plus 0.6, this is the y number of what? Eg orbital. So taking the differences of their energy, we can get what? The octahedral CFSE energy. Getting? So now, on the basis of the orbitals present in T2g set and Eg set, we can find the value of CFSE. Now, how can we find the value of CFSE? So, calculation of CFSE, that is del 0 or O, okay, for octahedral complex having different configuration. Now, different configuration, that is what? That is, suppose it is D1, suppose it is D2, and suppose it is D3. So, if the configurations are different, then how can we fill the electron in different orbitals? Getting? So, there is no change in the del O energy. It is because the 3 electrons, one by one, will fill in different orbital. That is, now the CFSE, okay, will be have for any of the ligand, okay, irrespective of it is weak ligand filled or if it is strong filled ligand. In any of the case, there will be no change. How it is nature? No change. It will be equal to, the electron will be filled in what? T2g orbital. The first electron will be filled in T2g orbital. That is what? Minus 0.4 multiplied by Now what? Only one electron will be there. Okay. While in case of this one, 0.6 multiplied by y. Now in y there is no electron. That is, you can call it what? Zero electron. There will be no electron. So the overall energy will be what? Minus 0.4. Isn't it? In case of D2 configuration, again minus 0.4 into the second electron will fill here, which is in T2G. So into 2. Okay. Plus 0.6 into again what? 0. There will be no electron. So its difference will be minus 0.80. In case of D3 configuration, again it is minus 0.4 into 2, okay, but not 2. There will be how many electrons? 3 electrons, okay, plus 0.6 into what? 0. No electron is there. Therefore, it is minus 1.2 energy. Isn't it? That means what? In case of, if the configuration is D1 or D3, then irrespective of type of ligand, the difference in the energy, that is the CFSE energy, will remain what? Same. Okay, there is no change. Okay, but in the case of, in the case of configuration is different. Configuration is different. That is what? D4 to D7. Okay, now 2 possibilities, 2 possibilities of del 0 in case of 2 different type of ligands approach to different type of ligands approach. Now, 2 different type of ligands approach means what? Means what will happen if it is weak field ligand, and what will happen if it is strong field ligand.